الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek help from Him, we ask forgiveness from Him, we repent to Him, we seek refuge in Him from our own evils and our own bad deeds. Anyone who has been guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is indeed guided. And anyone who has been misguided, he will never find a guardian to guide him. They bear witness, there is no deity except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone without any partner. They bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his messenger. O Allah, let your prayer, your peace and blessing be upon your servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. In continuation of the series of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ethics, we still with the ethic of al-istighfar, seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Isra, verses 41 to 44, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ولقد صرفنا في هذا القرآن ليذكروا وما يزيدهم إلا نفورا، قل لو كان معه آلهة كما يقولون إذن لابتغوا إلى ذي العرش سبيلا، سبحانه وتعالى عما يقولون علوا كبيرا، يسبح له السماوات والسبع والأرض ومن فيهن، وإن من شيء إلا يسبح بحمده ولكن لا تفقهون تسبيحهم إنه كان حليما غفورا. Indeed, in the Quran al-Kareem is a reminder to these people who reject the message, but this reminder they keep on them in a negative way that they don't accept. But if, as they say, the other gods with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then every god would like to go to the throne. And this is, the throne is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It would be like competition between gods. This is if there are more than one god. In reality, only one god, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is indeed the one. Praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever they say, and far away from whatever they describe. Within the heavens and the earth, all the creations praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, but you do not understand that they're praising. It means that all creations, all creatures, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All the animals, even the trees, everything, even the mountains and the rivers and everything around us praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them and their nature that only the humans and the jinn, they have the choice. But for human, we do not understand the praising of such creations. So, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left us to the day of judgment to judge us of what we have done in this life. If we've done good, we follow the right way, then we are to the paradise. If we did not, other than that, God forbid, whoever will be disobedient will go to the hellfire. إِنَّهُ كَانَ حَلِيمًا غَفُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most patient and the most forgiving. So in Allah kana haliman ghafura, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will just punish whoever will do wrongs, there's nobody, no creation will be, no human going to be on earth. Everybody will be punished and destroyed. As happened to other previous nations before. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left everything to the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge everybody what they have done. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most patient, the most forgiving. So this means that whatever we do, even we do wrongs, we should not give up. We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most forgiving, so we'll go and repent. So this innahu kana haliman ghafura. But do not take advantage of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala halim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most patient. Because you could be punished if you just take advantage of that. So, but always repent immediately. When you do something wrong, right away repent. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ وَلَوْ يُؤَخِذُهُمْ بِمَا كَسَبُوا لَعَجَّلْ لَهُمْ الْعَذَابِ بَلْ لَهُمْ مَوْعَدٌ لَنْ يَجِدُوا مِنْ دُونِهِ مَوْئِلًا. That's in Surah Al-Kahf, verse 58. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had this, his forgiveness first. غَفُور, he forgive. وَرَبُّكَ الْغَفُورُ, your Lord is the most forgiving. ذُو الرَّحْمَةِ, has the most, the mercy. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take everybody, whatever they have done, then the punishment will be near and they're going to be punished. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leave them for a specific date with the Day of Judgment. So this is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the people the opportunity to repent. Look how the best that you can have. You can make mistakes, but go back and repent. And over and over, whenever your clothes get dirty, you go to wash it. If you don't give up, don't say, oh, I'm making too many sins. No. As soon as you make a sin, immediately go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify yourself from such wrongdoings, so not to do it again. In Surah Al-Furqan, verse 4 to 6, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقال الذين كفروا إن هذا إلا إفك افتراه وأعانه عليه قوم آخرون فقد جاءوا ظلما وزورا وقالوا أساطير الأولين اكتتبها فهي تملى عليه بكرة وأصيلا قل أنزله الذي يعلم السر في السماوات والأرض إنه كان غفورا رحيما. So these people, the disbelievers, what they said that they said that whatever Prophet Muhammad came with something from his own, and other people from other religions or other people helped him. They said wrong. What they said is wrong. Even said that this is a previous myth been written, and somebody is telling him about it day and night. Because the Quran, for all the 23 years, the Quran is coming. And the Quran is coming. You see, the Quran is coming. This is a Quran in Arabic, and the Arabic is a miracle. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran in Arabic because this is what the Arab is doing the best in the language. The poets, so they're using the language the best. So this is a last long miracles. The Quran is going to last until the end, and it will never perish, and the Quran will be protected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody going to change it. So this is a living miracle and surviving miracle regardless. Whoever wants to touch it is not going to do anything to it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantee its preservance. It's the Quran going to survive. Nobody going to change it. Look, قل أنزله الذي يعلم السر في السماوات والأرض. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the unseen, the secrets in the heavens and earth. إنه كان غفورا رحيما. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed is the most merciful and the most merciful, the most forgiving and the most merciful. So these two together, forgiven and merciful, rahma. Look at this now. This is in Surah Al-Furqan, verse 63 to 70. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describing the believers, وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ, the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. The people who walk on earth humbly, they are humble. And if ignorance address them, they say peace. They don't initiate any struggles or any problems. والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما. And the people who spend their nights prostrating for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praying سجدا وقياما in prayer, your nights in prayers. والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما. They supplicate for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know what's going to happen at the end. Either paradise or hellfire. They are supplicating, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep the hellfire away from them. This is the goal, is to stay away from the hellfire, to go to the paradise. إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. They know the reality of the hellfire. It is the worst place to stay. ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما. And the people who spend in charity, they don't give lavishly, they don't give without measure, and also they don't hold tight. In between, the best thing to have in between, like the best matter is in the middle matter. It's be in the middle. لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا. They don't give a lot. They don't give lavishly, and they don't hold. وكان بين ذلك قواما. In between, the best matter is to be in that situation. والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما. الذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر. You always worship Allah سبحانه وتعالى alone, no partner, and you don't kill the people, and you don't commit adultery. And whoever will do that, killing and committing adultery, it's great sin that shouldn't, the believer would not do. يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا. And whoever will do that, the punishment will be doubled. And in the day of judgment, and they're going to stay in the hellfire forever if the people will do that without repenting. إلا من تاب, except the people who repent. If you do this wrong things, if you keep on doing it and you don't repent, then the hellfire is the end for you. But except, إلا من تاب, except whoever will repent and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وعمل عملا صالحا and do good deeds, فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. Whoever, when you repent, not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive you, but He will change your sins to good deeds. Your previous sins are going to be changed to good deeds. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful and the most forgiving. And knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there to forgive after you repent. And also in Surah Saba, verse 1-4, Alhamdulillah, الذي له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وله الحمد في الآخرة وهو الحكيم الخبير يعلم ما يلج في الأرض وما يخرج منها وما ينزل من السماء وما يعرج فيها وهو الرحيم الغفور. وقال الذين كفروا لا تأتين الساعة قل بلى وربي لتأتينكم عالم الغيب لا يعزب عنه مثقال ذرة في السماوات ولا في الأرض ولا أصغر من ذلك ولا أكبر إلا في كتاب مبين ليجزي الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك لهم مغفرة ورزق كريم. Now, praise for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For Him, indeed, everything in the heaven and the earth. And praise for Him in the hereafter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most wise and the most experienced. He knows everything. He's the most knowledgeable about everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's going to go to the earth and what's going to come out from it. Everything, even a drop, even a leaf or a small insect, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. Everything in the recorded. The disbeliever will say, There's no judgment. Everything, everybody after the death, nobody going to come. How come that bones and the dust going to come back into life? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the unseen. And nothing, not a mithqal dharra, that's dharra, the small atom, mithqal dharra, in the earth or in the heavens, and anything even smaller than the atom. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it, about what's smaller than the atom. And of course, now they discover things smaller than the atom. Or bigger, it's all in a clear book. Everything is written, everything is known. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has records for everything. Everything is nothing without record. لِيَجْزِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمَلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ مَغْفَرَةٌ وَرِزْقٌ كَرِيمٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward the people who believe and also and the people who will do good deeds, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mercy for them, has forgiveness for them, and also has abundance of risk for them, that you're going to have. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous. قل إنما أنا منذر وما من إله إلا الله الواحد القهار رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما العزيز الغفار. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell Prophet Muhammad that to say that I'm warning you. There is no God except Allah. This is the most important thing, to believe in the oneness of Allah. There is no God except Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most powerful. He is the Lord of this heaven and the earth. And in between, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the exalted and the most forgiving. So أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله عسى أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication at this time. الحمد لله. والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. In سورة الزمر verse 5. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق يكور الليل على النهار ويكور النهار على الليل وسخر الشمس والقمر كل يجري لأجل مسمى ألا هو العزيز الغفار. الله سبحانه وتعالى He's the one who created the heaven and the earth. And الله سبحانه وتعالى created the night and the day and the whenever the night is end, the day is come, and so on. It's in the cycle, day and night. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the sun for the service of the earth, the people. Could you imagine? There would be no life, there was no sun here. Everybody will freeze. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the sun also the degree of the heat, that to be acceptable. For some other planets is very, very hot. Nobody can live there. Or it's very, very cold. Nobody can live there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had the sun in a specific distance, like exactly the distance where is bearable, where people and the plants and the life could continue. It's measurement. This is not like by itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had everything in accuracy that for a reason, for the life to continue until he decided to end. وَسَخَّرَ الشَّمْسُ وَالْقَمَرُ كُلٌّ يَجْرِي لِأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. And the sun and the moon is moving to a specific period of time. Until the time end, also they will, the sun will come from the west and everything will be finished. But everything go in order. But that order, when you know how this, the accuracy of that order is not by itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not sleep. It's awake all the time and keep everything under control. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never sleep. Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will sleep, everything will be messed up. Everything in accuracy and a perfect control, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the control of everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most praised and the most forgiving. In Surah Al-Zumar, verse 52-53, أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدُرُ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَى أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. The people, they don't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who give the provisions for, you give more risk for people and hold risk for others for a reason. For the people to believe, is everybody has destined for something. So don't say, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had for you, do your best, but this, be content, because this is because if you may be very rich, you will not be a good person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you that way to be the best you can. So whatever your situation you are in, do your best, but leave things for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. The people who committed too many sins, don't despair, don't give up, don't think that the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not for you. Like this man in the previous nation that who killed 99 people, and he want to repent. And he went to somebody, a worshiper, and told him, I killed the 99 people. Is any forgiveness, any repentance for me? He said, no, you killed too many people. He killed him. He killed that person, the worshiper, and he killed the 100. And he went again to somebody, asked for help, and people told him, go to this scholar. It's different between a scholar and worshiper. It's very important to know before you give consultation. Don't say something without knowledge. When he went to the scholar, the person, the alim, it's called alim, he told him, I killed 100 people. Is there any repentance for me? He said, yes. How I can repent? Say, where you live, and ask him. And he told you, first thing is to go to live in a community where these people there, they are good people. Surround yourself with the good people. Stay away from the bad people that you used to live with, stay with. And the man took the advice of that scholar, and he started walking to that village or that place where they had the good people to live. And in the middle, or before some place, and while he was in the way, he died. Look, he did not do anything good yet. He's just in his way to do the good things. And then the angels of the mercy and angel of the punishment, they struggle with each other. Oh, he did not do anything good, so we take him to the hellfire. And the other mercy angel said, oh, he's going to go. He was planning, he has the intention to go to live and to do good. We'll take him. So, and then another angel came and told him, measure the distance. If he's near the village that he is going to, the good village, then he's going to be in the mercy side. If he's still in the side of that bad place he was with, then he's still in the wrong side. Then even he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pushed his body to be near the good side. And so just because of his intention to do good things. And even look at this, the prostitute that she all her acts is bad, but when she went to a well and she drank water and came out to find a dog that he was very thirsty. And what she did, she went back again and with her shoes brought water for the dog to drink. And for that act, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive her sin. So don't underestimate what you can do to be forgiven. anything, or even whenever you do something, consider this is the one that's going to move you from the wrong side to the good side. Even not only the wrong side, the bad side, there's also there's some place in between. There's the people who is going, their bad deeds equal the wrong deeds. The wrong deeds equal the good deeds. Then they are in between. Then they're going to be left for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So always think that, oh, if, even if you have all the good deeds equal to the bad deeds, think that what you're going to do, the specific small good deeds, are going to move you to the good deeds side. So always don't underestimate what you can do good to reach that level. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفُرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Oh, my slaves who didn't despair, if you did wrong, and the, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy is more than what could be under any wrong measurement. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will give all, He will forgive all sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful and the most forgiving. When Amr ibn al-As and Khalid ibn al-Walid came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Amr ibn al-As, when he came and when he was extending his hand to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take shahada, then Amr said, oh Prophet of Allah, he took his hand and said, how about my previous sins that you did before that? So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam don't you know that when you become Muslims, all your previous sins are going to be changed to good deeds? So that when you do bad and you repent, your bad deeds will be transferred to be good deeds. So أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم. أدعو الله أن تكون هذه ساعة إجابة. Supplicate, may Allah accept our supplication this time. O Allah, help us to purify ourselves in body, mind, heart, and spirit. O Allah, do not let our hearts deviate from the truth now that we have been guided, but grant us mercy from your very presence, for you are the grantor of bounties without measure. My Lord, help me to perfect my prayer, and of my descendants, our Lord, accept this prayer. Our Lord, forgive me and my parents and all believers until the day of resurrection. Glory to Allah, Lord of Majesty and Honor, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family and all his companions. Praise to Allah, Lord of all creations. Aqul qawli hadha astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa aqim as-salah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayyul salat, hayyul falah, qabtu salat, qabtu salat. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah.
Istaqimu warhamukum Allah. Allahu Akbar.
Allahu Akbar.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح الحمد ربك واستغفر إنه كان توابا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ربنا لك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله.